do it a lot cheaper. I remember running my ad in the Yellow Pages and it was $200 a month. And I paid it. It was like $225, $250. It was something up there, but it was high. Okay. So nowadays, Sheila, it's a lot easier to get your product out there, your services, your programs, because I know that you have a dynamic brand. And now it's a lot easier. So we're going to talk about throughout Project 63 how to position it properly online, because it's less expensive to do that online, and then also reach more people, and is more targeted as opposed to advertising on television or even the radio stations. I remember doing the radio station and thinking I was thebomb.com, but the radio station cost a lot of money. I remember having the personalities come out, the radio personalities, the DJs come out and they bring the van, and it was an extra $200 if you wanted the van to sit outside of your establishment. We ain't doing none of that no more. So that is, that's not going to work. So let's see, what other challenges are we having? Shelly, you're not all over the planet. You'll be fine. Just stay in the digital space. You're going to be right on target. Because if you tell me you're passing out postcards at the subway station, I'm going to get you. Okay? Because I used to do that. That's why I know this. Okay? I used to be at the subway station during rush hour handing out postcards. Because that was just the only way to do it. And so now, you don't have to be all over the place. Let's stay in that digital space. And I do know, Sheila, you have a lot of pieces already recorded. So you just need to figure out where do you put those pieces and how do you run them? Who do you target them to? And all of those good things. Okay. And you need a promo video too. I don't know if you have one done already, but a promo video is needed too. Let's see who else. Crystal said, defining her personal image and marketing. Now, Crystal, I saw a picture of you not too long ago. I think she went to a Christmas party or something.
Oh, New Year's. Looking hot, honey.
Looking hot. Okay. So I don't know what you did that day, but do that every day because you were looking good. So we're talking about the personal image. It's one of those things, guys, where you have to make a decision to do, because when you work from home, like I do, it's many days I'm like, I ain't putting on no lipstick, so you don't see me doing a Facebook Live, because you get comfortable. I get comfortable too, to the point where I don't put on lipstick, where I don't even get out of the sweats and stuff that I've been laying around in all day. So trying to be cute every single day of the week, it is a commitment. And Crystal, the thing with the image, because I saw how you looked, I was like, dang, Crystal's looking hot, hot, hot. Now, how do we keep that up? How do we do that every day? That is something that we have to make a conscious decision and say, every single day, I'm going to fix my hair, put on some foundation and some lipstick, some lip gloss. It's a conscious decision of doing so. Because sometimes I'm going to just run to the store real quick and pick up my prescription.
I feel you, Crystal. I'm in sweats and t-shirts a lot too, but you know.
Yeah. So it's first of all, making the commitment to do so. So that was one of the things. So when you do your lives, when you do those type of things, I try to wear bright colors a lot. So if you guys notice in my lives,
as we sit here in all this black.
Right. When I do, well, I dressed up for y'all today. Okay. I said, oh, I'm going to go put on something real cute. And she got her sparkles on. So we purposely put this together today. But your image is important because it speaks to you. And it speaks to you. And I'm not saying everybody got to be weaved up. And, you know, it's not a certain look. Okay. It doesn't make a difference. The difference is being able to connect with your audience for your particular brand. Okay. Because you might not want to be a transformational coach and everything fake. They'd be like, she might not be happy with herself.
Yeah, thanks.
So, you know, so you got to kind of, you know, figure out your space, your zone, and just be authentically you. Mm-hmm. That's first and foremost, because whatever is on the out on the inside, that definitely comes out. So don't try to be something that you're not. I remember going through a personal brand with a client of mine, and she felt like, well, I don't want to wear weave, or I don't want to do this. That's not my style. But I know that's what the people want. Not necessarily. It doesn't work like that. Because the one thing that we do here at Rockstar 360 is have you stay authentically you. Because the minute you try to be somebody else, you're not going to do that great of a job. It's hard being somebody else. It's easier being you. And people need what you have. So when it comes to that image, the main part is how do we keep it up? You know, because once you do it one time, Crystal, like we saw the picture, mm-hmm. If you go to another party and you don't look like that picture, we're going to be like, hey, Crystal. So, you know, once you step out there, sometimes people expect you to look like that all the time. So when you're on a speaking platform, you know, like Dr. Nadia had to speak this week here in the DMV, and she said, I gotta get my hair done before I come.
You can't show up looking raggedy, seriously.
You can't show up looking raggedy, but guess what? She has set the tone like a year ago, right?
Well, we set a different tone.
A year ago, because it's been a year since you've been through your personal brand makeover.
Yep, it was last February.
We had you outside in the cold taking.
Just stop.
I'm telling you guys, when you go through a personal brand makeover, anything goes. You know how they always tell the story about the Sports Illustrated models and the swimsuits mm-hmm. for the cover? They're on the beach doing these photo ops, but yeah,
I feel like that freezing. Minus the big check that typically comes after that.
But it's freezing cold, but they have to act like it's okay. So we were shooting Dr. Nadia's videos, and she had to walk around the lake, and we got some B-roll footage, thanks to our girl Kimberly, and it was cold.
It was freezing.
Like,
y'all, first of all, I'm from Phoenix, Arizona. I live in the desert. Desert. We typically, anything below 60 is pushing our freezing buttons. And to make matters worse, I was born and raised in Florida. Y'all see the theme here?
The sun.
So, sun, surf, sun, heat. So, you know, to fly into the DMV in February, after being delayed because of snowstorms in between me and getting here, yeah. I was just freezing, so it's all good though. I survived. It didn't kill me, but I still don't like the cold.
Look, we didn't say it was easy. We're just trying to get the right photo op, the right B-roll footage, so that we can promote your brand properly. Mm-hmm. And the thing is, we don't just do this in the summertime.
That's true. And I would, you know, one of the things I would say, Lyric, though, even, you know, as you're thinking about your personal brand and making those changes, it's really a true statement when mm-hmm. you think about, you have to do things that make you uncomfortable. Like if it were me, I clearly would have planned all of that for like a nice June perfect day somewhere, because then I would have been trying to escape the heat from the desert. But you know, that was just a testament even to myself that I would be willing to go out there and to not be looking like no. I think one of the biggest things for me going through that process was the trust factor, because there were a lot of things that when I got on a plane in Phoenix, I had no idea what I was walking into, literally. Like, I knew very little. It was like, get on the plane, get off the plane, call Larry, right? So it was a really cryptic experience. And being someone who is in control, and I want to control things, and, you know, being a person that I have a background in project management, we know everything. So to be a part of that was huge. As far as just trusting the process, trusting the professionals that I was working with, trusting Lyric and her vision for what could be as part of that transformation was big. And so there were a lot of things that we went into, and I know we're going to talk more about, I don't want to get ahead of what you got laid out, Lyric, but you know, there were lots of things. I just walked in and I was like, here I am. What you got? And it was very scary. Just sitting there not knowing what you are going to, what you're going to walk away with. So,
right. Good. And the thing is, having somebody who's coachable, mm-hmm. even scared, being coachable, because the thing is, I had an idea of what I wanted for her. I had a look. I had, and remember we was talking about earlier, not changing who you are. So I knew she had sister locks in her head. So it wasn't like, okay, we're going to cut that all off and, you know, we're going to put a relaxer in and, you know, just change who you are.
Thank you.
So we don't do that, but we knew, and with my extensive 30 years in the beauty industry, I knew that there were other ways of doing things. Mm-hmm. So I knew in order to change locks, for example, is leave the length. You can pin it up, you can make it curly, or you can add some color. Ding, 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 ding. Color. That was it. So because color brings out just a whole new look. Mm-hmm. To your own natural style. And so the thing is, I told Dr. Nadia, we're going to give you a little color.
I'm breathing.
Okay. So I did not tell her in the beginning, though, that this color is going to be blonde and it's going to be three different shades of blonde.
Yeah, she left out a few important details.
Now, how many of you all would have like just been like, all right, cool, just whatever, three different shades of blonde, I'll take that, and just be okay with it.
And not see anything until it was all over. Like, yeah, just, I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah. So the thing is, I knew what I had. I said, okay, I did my research because I had all these pictures of different styles, different options. I saw different colors. And then not only that, it wasn't so much just the hairstyle, it was also the clothing. We did the clothing as well. And it was kind of like, oh, wow. I like this look, I like this look, I like this look. So with all of that going on, I had all these ideas, but that doesn't mean everything fits. Because once you get your client there, you got to try all that stuff on, because everything doesn't work for everybody. Right. So what I thought might work, some did, some didn't.
Right.
Some of them was a little poofy. Some of them was a little like, not.
Some of it was just a hot, flaming mess. Okay.
And the thing is, we went on this journey to change really just kind of the overall look, if you will. Not the person, but just the image that her potential audience is going to see, because you were getting ready to do a launch.
Yeah.
So new launch, new look, new Nadia.
Yeah.
And we did makeovers. You know, we pulled the glam squad in, right? There's no way in East China we don't pull the glam squad in. And so we went from place to place. We tried on different outfits. And the thing is, ladies, it was a little tiring. Whoever thought we'd kind of be like, oh, one more store. Because, you know, as ladies, you know, the store is it. But, you know, it was a little pressure on us. Because we had this hashtag, no, you know, do not
fail. Do not fail. Yeah.
Let me get that right. We had this hashtag, do not fail. So with that being said, it was a little pressure on us. And in this industry, and even in the entertainment industry, guys, they don't care that, oh, you have 10 minutes to do this, or you have just an hour to pull this look together. Lights, camera, action. It is what it is. You have to make it happen. And the thing is, you can't break. Because there were times we was like, oh, my gosh. Okay, we got one more story. We got to hit this one story. And it got to the point because, if you don't know, Dr. Nadia and I kind of work in excellence. So we want it to be right, or it's just not being done. There's right. No in between. There's no wavering. So with our, you know, way of thinking, we was like, it has to be right. And one thing I could say is having a client who feels the same way I feel, you know, so when the pressure came, she understood it, you know, because if any of you all been with me in the studio, you know, I push, but it's because greatness is the only option.
Right.
So when your potential client is looking at your videos, they can't be warped. They can't, you know, be off. You can't, you know, have your necklace twisted. And, you know, you guys know I go in, I fix your hair. I fix your jewelry. I will hold down Spanx. I have pushed down wigs. I have literally been in the studio on the ground, laying on my back, holding down somebody's Spanx while they do their presentation. And during a PowerPoint.
That was not me, by the way.
No, that wasn't her. You know, but the thing is, it's excellence or nothing. So when you're going through your personal brand makeover, you guys, you have to realize that this is the goal. There's no, well, I think I'll land right here. This is too much for me. No, it's never too much when you're trying to make an impact on your audience. So as we were going through it, we was like, okay, time is running out, but failing was not an option.
Yeah.
So there was a time, remember the time we were in there, we was, I think we was getting ready to go into one of our last stores. It was like, oh my God, we have to find that one little piece, that one last piece. And we were both like, oh my God, this one here starts praying.
Who else you don't call on? We clearly were not being successful. We need to say, oh.
So this one right here called on Jesus, honey.
Okay, no shame in my game.
So I said, well, I better sit down and listen to this one because clearly we need a little help here. But that's because our expectation for the outcome was so great and so high. And we were in a time frame because she had a launch. The launch was like coming up. You can't fail.
Well, one thing, Lyric, because I know we talked a little bit about the actual experience, but you know, why, right? Why would you jump on a plane, fly clear across the country in the cold to do a personal brand makeover? And one of the reasons that really motivated me was I knew it was time to step up my game. I had been out there speaking and working and to build my business for years. And I was the former corporate girl. So there was a certain type of look that I had. And especially at that time when I first launched my business, my focus was corporate, working with corporate clients, doing corporate training. So, you know, corporate has a look. And it took me a while to kind of break out of the uniform, if you will. And even with that, I only went so far. So one of the things that I was able to do in those early days, even before I met Lyric, was to start leveraging more color. So when I was in corporate, my uniform, if you will, was pretty much black, gray, brown, navy blue, you know, really exciting colors, very sexy. And no pops at all, no personality. And so once I started my business and I really started, you know, my focus was women and leadership, and we're going to really, you know, lead like a lady and do all these really cool things. And it's part of my brand, so it fit. And I was at a conference, I believe it was 2013. And that's when it hit me, because someone actually mirrored that back to me. They were like, you're like this pop of pink in the sea of navy blue, which is true. Mm. I had a nice pink blazer and a black pencil skirt, and everyone else was in the uniform, black, navy blue, gray, brown, you know, right. So there I was, that pop. And so I started to leverage that in my brand. You know, like my newsletter is now a pop of pink because I started to get feedback from those that I was working with. So that worked for a while, and I was leveraging that, and so it was working, it's doing its thing, and things started to shift. So as you're building your business and you're building your brand, things will start to shift in your brand, and you have to shift along with it. And one thing that was really shifting, and two things, one, my business overall was shifting, so I wasn't as corporate focused, and two, I was leveraging very little video in my business, very little. I don't like, still struggle with it. You know, like being on camera is probably not my first option. It's like, yeah, what else can we do? Yeah. But I also understand the power of video, especially when you're thinking about developing and building a global enterprise, right? You can't just, only so many places I can be global with when staying in Phoenix, or, you know, even flying within the country. Yes. So that really, that helped. And, you know, having conversations with Lyric, my mentors at the time that we did the launch, it was like, okay. And speaking of, for a moment with mentors, because let me be honest, I didn't wake up and say, okay. You know, like, I just wanted that was not my idea. But when it was presented to me, understanding where it is that I wanted to go in my business, that's when I was like, you know what, Nadia, it may be uncomfortable, but a lot of things are uncomfortable. I'm a natural introvert. Me getting up and speaking in front of crowds is uncomfortable, but I do it. So, and I enjoy doing it even through the discomfort. So that was huge for me to make that decision to say, okay, honey, dear Toby, I'm going to be hopping on a plane. I'll be gone for another week.
Oh, you know, to work on.
Right. I have a husband.
And we're just going to change your wife.
Right. I have a spouse who had no idea. And it was, and my husband's an engineer. So to say, yeah, I really don't have a whole lot of details about how this is going to work. All I know is I'm doing this and we're having a launch. It's going to be great. And he's like, okay. So that was a big reason why. So as you're looking at your personal brand, because like Lyric said, when you show up in person, online, offline is very important. And as you're looking at those types of clients that you want. Mm-hmm. So it was funny because at my event last October, Take the Leap, we talked about your client avatar, who you wanted to work with, what are you doing to attract that person? And one of the ladies raised her hand. She says, Dr. Nadia, you know, I want to attract like a Roxy or a Rochelle, but I keep getting a bone quickly, right? So it's like, well, okay, something is off in your marketing and your branding, and you have to look at every little piece. And one of the ways that it starts, you know, with your look, how you show up at networking events, how you show up at your live videos, how you show up in your other marketing, but also what is your online presence, you know? So it was a big deal. And it was definitely a faith walk in that whole process of, you know, flying out here, getting off the plane. I met with Lyric. We had some basics. My flight was delayed because there were no flights into Chicago. So I had to be rerouted.
Oh, yeah, remember.
Yes, it was crazy. And so I get here, literally like maybe an hour and a half ish before the malls close. We already pretty much missed a day of our project. So that really put a lot of pressure on all the things that we wanted to do, and we got it done. And so just thinking about that, but also being willing to have mentors that I would say that my mentors that I've been very fortunate to have a lot of great mentors and coaches throughout the time that I took the leap and started my business. And one of the things that I have been most blessed by is having them be able to look at me and see something greater. They're like, yeah, you might be good, but you can be better. You might even be great and you can be better, you know? Mm-hmm. And so to just to have someone look at you and be like, wow, and to take it to that next level. And then they connected me with this girl right here.
and to piggyback on the being great part.
Yeah.
Some personal branding is not about whether, I'm already good. I'm already great. So I don't need this, that, and a third. You can be great and no one knows who you are. Okay.
Preach.
That is real life. Mm-hmm. That's real talk. The thing is, and I always use the example, a lot of people, I use sports because I like sports. But I know a lot of ladies don't know about sports, but they do know about the whole Michael Jordan and Dennis Rodman era. So I always use them as an example. We know Michael Jordan was great. Mm-hmm. We saw him going to the basket, tongue out, dunking, doing the whole nine. We already know that he's a superstar, okay? So when we look at Dennis Rodman, we know who he is too. Mm-hmm. Do y'all know how many points he put up? Do you know how many times you see him go to the basket? Because he's the big man. He's in the middle. He just didn't do a lot of points. That wasn't his thing. But he created a brand for himself to the point where you don't know any of his stats. Do you even know when he retired?
Really don't.
We remember when Jordan retired, right? Yeah, it was a big deal. And we know he scored a lot of points. But I always use Dennis Rodman as an example because Dennis Rodman created this monster, if you will, of a brand. We don't care how many points Dennis Rodman put up. We don't know. As a matter of fact, I don't even know when he retired. But if I saw him walking down the street, oh my God, that's Dennis Rodman. Can I get a picture? Y'all know I'm going to get a selfie, right? Can I get a selfie? Can I get an autograph? That's Dennis Rodman. We would know him from across the room. We don't know how many baskets he made, how many points he scored. We don't know when he retired. We don't know those things. But he has created this thing called a brand. Now, there were other players on the team that played just as much as Dennis did, had the same scoring, you know, capability, made the same amount of points. We don't even know their name. Why is that? And there were other players that scored more than Dennis Rodman. But why don't we know their name? Why don't we know their name? If they walked past us, we wouldn't even know who they were.
Right.
That's what I'm saying, guys. It's not about how many points they made. It's who created that brand, who created that lifestyle outside of the game. Some people are superstars, yes, because they have that natural ability. Some people are superstars because they created their own doggone hype. Mm-hmm. And that's the best example I can give you, is comparing him to another basketball player who may have had more points, but we don't know who that guy is. And don't even care. But we know who Dennis Rodman is. We may have said that this dude is crazy, but he created that. And we know exactly who he is. And it's the same thing with your brand. You can be great, but do people know who you are? You know? And Crystal asked, does your brand consistently grow and change? It does. Because you have to change with the times. I remember, I'm almost too embarrassed to say. I remember back in the day when I was in the beauty industry, I had these fingernails that came out to about right here. I mean, like real long, like Coco from SWV long.
Things we learn about Lyric.
They were long, all 10 of them, really, really long. And I was able to maneuver, because I know y'all probably saying, now how did she wipe her tail? I was able to cook, do everything. But the point that I'm making was, I thought it was the style. You know, Coco had it, Lyric had it. It was the style. And you can't wear that right now. That does not look right. So the look changes. You have to change with the time. It's like we talked about earlier, sending postcards. You just can't do that. You have to make those changes. So what I want to talk about to Dr. Nadia is, you went through your personal brand makeover. Mm-hmm. Okay. You had your launch, and we're going to give you guys a sneak peek of what it looked like all at the end as well. But did you see a difference once you had this? Because, you know, we put it all out there for the masses. We did
I was with you. We did the
sneak peek behind the scenes of her personal brand makeover. And I was taking pictures of, like, behind her, you know, her back. So you couldn't really see into the final product. Final reveal, rather, excuse me. So since then, what has been the change? What are the results of going through that? Because you don't want to do all that and nothing happens.
Right. I would say, one, it just showed me a different side of me. So one of the things that Stella had a question.
I know.
I love Sorry, Stella. I was looking at questions back. One of the things that Lyric did was she created the alter. What was it? Nadia B. Dr. Nadia, and then we had Nadia B. And just kind of, you know, so it was really just kind of watching that process. But it was also really fun because it was like, you know, what would you do if you kind of stepped outside of the box around what people expected Dr. Nadia to be? How they expected her to act, how they expected her to look. And she also challenged me to just kind of explore some different things. So that really, one, it was just this greater confidence in, okay, I'm not going to die. Because one of my bigger concerns was I'm putting a lot of faith and trust in what other people think. And we fight a lot of times as women, especially to gain that sense of independence and confidence and self-esteem, right? And so I'm kind of like, I'm cool with who I am. And so there was that concern around, am I going to look like myself when I leave? And is it something that I'm going to be excited about? So that was one of the big things for me. So we do the process. It was great. I survived. And I was like, oh, I can live with this. This is cool. This is all right. I'm good. And, you know, my husband gave me 2 thumbs up. So he was like, yes, get on the plane. Come home, girl. So, yes, we were excited about that. And it just really, you know, it took it to the next level. I also learned a lot through the process. I think that, you know, people look at the you watch it kind of unfold online or however that played out. And you don't realize that there were so many lessons to be learned even behind the scenes. So there was a lot of training involved as well, especially for the on-camera piece, because that was definitely an area where if no one had ever invented a video camera, I think I would have been okay. But that was just where we were. And so to get that additional training and insight on being on camera, things, you know, do's and don'ts. But also for me, the biggest one was just being confident and okay with camera's not going to kill you. You're going to be fine. And because it leveraged, you know, now you are able to reach such a broader audience. And so to see that, because it's one thing for someone to tell you that, it's another thing for you to see it and to start to see the results from people commenting, from opportunities, doors suddenly opening because people are like, oh, I saw you. And I was like, where? And they're like, I saw you on some video. Okay.
They saw you.
Right. And so, you know, you kind of went from, what did someone give you feedback? I was like flying under the radar because it wasn't like I wasn't doing things.
Yes.
But I wasn't doing it at that level. I wasn't leveraging those different platforms. And I wasn't really getting out there in that way. And going through the personal brand makeover also allowed me to express my personality in a different way. So it wasn't like Lyric was like, you're going to go from here to here, but she just kind of brought out more of me and more of the fun, not so serious side of me, and to really be able to bring that into my brand. And so when I do events, because, you know, some of the things people are like, okay, you have doctor, right? That's good. That builds credibility. So it's good. I'm not knocking it. I went through the process. But on the other side of that is people then are like, are you boring? You know, are you going to be that? I mean, think about it. Most of us, you went to college, you've seen the boring professor. He's like, okay. You may be qualified, but are you going to put my peeps to sleep?
Yeah.
And so to be able to really leverage more of that playful, fun, engaging side was also, and just be able to look at the photos or look at how I showed up and be like, okay, she's not your stereotypical doctor professor. So I think that was also a big one, but there were clear indications and results to my bottom line. So there were ways in which that my business definitely
You made
grew.
More money? Mm-hmm. Oh, she said she made more money because she went through a personal brand makeover.
I mean, that's the whole point, right? To see the return on your investment.
Well, but it's nothing like somebody that has a little proof. So, you know, because if I say it, but if that person that actually went through the process says that it has helped them in their business, that's a winner.
And it did. You know, I remember I went through, and you don't realize who's watching you. I think that's the big thing.
Yes.
You hear, you know, your mom probably told you, my mom, you know, watch what you do. And I thought it was one of those mother mind tricks. Watch what you do because someone's always watching.
Yeah.
Nothing is more true, especially now with social media. Back then when I was young, I didn't have to worry about that piece. But I actually received a call from a colleague, and we've been, you know, friends and colleagues for years. She's actually a former coach, actually. And she goes, Nadia, I saw some photos of you online. And what is this? And based on that, she was like, you encouraged me to step my game up. So not only
was it just for me? But, you know, my friends and colleagues were like, well, all shots, not, you know, Nadia stepped it up. I need to step it up. And it was like, oh, and it just created this synergy. So there was also this entire ripple effect that I had no clue was going to be a result of it. So it was really a great experience. It was a very stressful experience. And in that, it also taught me I'm a lot tougher than I thought. And, you know, talk about thinking on your feet. I would call Toby and tease him. I was like, I swear that I feel like I'm on a reality TV show right now. And I'm sleep deprived and I'm food deprived and there's a lot of stuff coming at me and I'm out of my comfort zone and I'm cold. And somebody expects me to smile and be happy on camera when I really just want to have some chocolate. So, but it was, you know, so those were some of the elements. And not that all of it has to be that way. Like she said, we were in the middle of a launch. There were a lot of things going, a lot of moving pieces in a compressed amount of time because I don't live here. And so, you know, I can't be gone forever. And we wanted to get those elements in place and just really think through that. And so just really thinking about it, but it was one of those things I would say, Lyric, that it was like, man, when you look back, now I can look back a year later and be like, honestly, and I hate
some before pictures.
I hate that I'm going to say this out loud, especially if a certain person should ever hear and watch this video. But if I had to do it all over again, I would. Even the cold, walking around the lake, freezing my bun buns off, I would. It was worth it. It was truly worth it.
I know you're talking about too.
Right, but it was truly worth it. And it was just, And like I said, my business, my brand just went to a whole nother level. The way I was viewed, the perception around me changed. And for the positive. And it was just a great way to really just leverage all of that. And so I'm really thankful. And, you know, Lyric makes it fun. She's very professional. Like you said, we're both are very anal when it comes to operating in excellence. And so I think we probably added a lot of extra pressure to ourselves as far as process wise. But to really just to have that trust. And that vision was huge. And to be able to have someone just to pull that out. And then to be able to look back a year later and say, wow, here are the results of making that decision. And it all begins with a decision. It's a choice. I could have easily just been like, you know what? I don't want to do that for my launch. Let's just kind of stick with status quo. It's inconvenient for me to fly 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
You had all the excuses you could.
Right. To, you know, right. And so I could have just been discouraged for us losing pretty much an entire day from the process. There were so many opportunities to just be like over it. But we just kept going and pushed through it. And so I encourage you to, as you think about your brand, it seems like a buzzword, but it really does make a difference. And when you think about the type of clients that you want to work with, who do they need you to be in order to even be able to hear from you?
Yeah.
Because you hear from, you know, I do these trainings and people are like, oh, I want to work with high-end clients, but they don't have a high-end presence.
Ooh,
and so
say that again.
You want to work with high-end clients and you don't have a high-end presence. And so that could definitely impact how people respond to you. What is does your brand speak high end? When you walk in a room, does it scream high Nordstrom or does it scream Walmart? And there's nothing against either one.
Right.
That could be your approach, but you have to think about the total package. And I think sometimes we overlook that. And so for me, as I thought about, okay, I have this vision to have a global brand, a global presence. I can't continue to stay hidden in Phoenix and expect that to happen magically. Like
pretty
there are
much.
Certain things that I need to be strategic, start doing strategically in order to make that happen.
Yeah, and it's funny because once you start getting out there, people will expect you to show up now, you know, a certain way. I remember, I forgot where I was going, walking into this building and somebody was coming out. And you know, you kind of just hold the door. She held the door for me because I was kind of going in before she can come out. And she said, oh, rock star, right? I was like a horrible.
That always happens.
It was late night. And I said, ooh, rock star down, rock star down. I said, hey, they expect you to show up. Once you set it out there, they expect you to show up. So you got to keep this thing up. It's not just for the photo op. Mm-hmm. It's not just for the video. It's for when you're on the stage. It's for when you never know. Because as your audience grow, they are everywhere.
Every.
Everywhere.
And that, I'm so glad you brought that up. That was another concern I had, because I'm like, Crystal, if I'm not on the road, I'm at home. And I'm like, I like my anonymity. Like, I just kind of like being, there's an advantage. You like, and it's, what is the word I'm looking for? It's a dichotomy. I think that's the word I'm looking for, where that's part of me wants to grow a global brand, but the other part of me wants to stay hidden. I chill, like, you know, because I would like being able to go to the grocery store with yoga pants, t-shirt, and a hair in a ponytail. Like, that was great. And so, but I knew I just had to get over it, right? It was like, you just get over it. Because this is bigger than you.
It is.
And you suck it up. And so recently, this just happened. I spoke at an event last month in Phoenix. And so right before I left to come out here for this, I was getting my hair done. And the lady in the chair, she looks at me and she goes, were you at a recent... She's like, were you at a recent church launch? Because I spoke to the women's group Friday.
Yeah,
and then I went back to their new location, dedication, or whatever that is called. And the pastor said, you know, hey, Dr. Nadia, thank you so much for coming. Have me stand up, wave to everybody. And, you know, he said, you know, thank you so much for being with us on Friday with the ladies. I don't think nothing of it, right? I'm there, I'm supporting, you know, my friend. I'm so excited. I met the ladies.
Right.
I do my wave. I get in a car. I go home.
What wave did you do like this?
Not exactly, but it was close, right? Yeah, everybody. And she looked at me and I was like, crap. I didn't know her. There were tons of people there. Didn't know who she was. She didn't come up and say hello. It was nothing. And she looked at me. And she was like, that was you. I remember your hair. Go, lo and behold, it was the hair.
Three colors of blonde.
It was up and it was doing something. And I was like, it's true. People are watching.
They're watching.
And I'm so glad, you know, because sometimes, and it's sometimes it can be a lot of pressure, because you have to think, like, you know, how are you acting? Because I always want my brand to be consistent. Yes. So a lot of, you know, times people will say, oh my gosh, you're just you. Mm-hmm. And that's me. So other than sometimes some minor road rage, but outside of that, I'm pretty chill most of the time. So yeah, it was huge, but it was that brand consistency.
Yeah.
And you know, I knew to show up, and I'm glad, you know, I didn't have one of them days where it's like, oh, it's just, you know, right. Sometimes like, oh, it's just a church event. I'll put my hair in a ponytail. Who cares?
Right, okay.
And it's like,
I'm going in Jesus' house. They love everybody.
He said, come as you are. Come as you are.
It's okay.
Yeah.
No big deal. So it's funny, but also it's just a matter of really letting go, guys, because when it comes to changing your image, if you will, you have to let go. You have to, like, put your guards down. You can't say, well, I don't want to wear that. I don't want to wear this. That's not me. But when working with me, we had that conversation first, because I have to know who you are.
Yeah.
To know how and which direction I'm going to go in when
it
comes
to. And that's part of the assessment, right?
So I have to know, you know, where you are, you know. Some people are top heavy. Some people are bottom heavy. Some people got natural hair. Some people have no hair. I mean, it's just.
We need to order some hair.
We can order some hair. I mean, some people just, like, you know, look good in bobs. It just all depends. Some people look good in yellow. Some don't. You know, somebody like me, it might look like all one color if I put on yellow. So, you know, you got to be careful. I've been blended in with my shirt. So some of the things, but you have to let go.
Yeah.
You have to trust the experts and know that the look that they're trying to give you is not far-fetched. We're not trying to change you as an individual, but just give you a little pop on the visual and release it. Because I remember us walking in a store and you picked up a dress and said, I picked up the dress. I said, oh, well, what about this one? You said, oh, that's something I would wear. I said, oh, putting it back.
She really needed
it. I didn't want her
to throw it back like it was hot or something was wrong with it. I was like, seriously?
I didn't want her to wear what she normally would have wore. I don't want her to just be comfortable in what she already has in her closet. I wanted something totally, totally different. And so to pick up something, and she said, oh yeah, I would wear that, and put it back then. I already knew that that would take her back into her norm. And so she was kind of like, really? Really, dude?
Yeah, that face.
Really? And I put it back. So it's real funny, but you have to let go. Trust me, I will not have you looking like somebody that your family can't recognize. Okay? They're just going to say, ooh, look at my sis. Or them old boyfriends going to say,
just shut down the inbox.
Just like, sorry. That was them.
Stella has a question. I think Lyric is in line with what you're talking about. She said, what if you don't know your personal brand style?
That's a good one, Stella. And it's more so, let me say this. It's kind of hard to figure it out all by yourself. Mm-hmm. Okay. Sometimes you need experts that are in the hair industry. Sometimes you need a fashion stylist. Sometimes you need a makeup artist because you might have deep setting eyes and they want to do something that bring them out. That is their expertise. Okay. So we as individuals, sometimes we don't have all those components. We don't know the answers to all of those things. Now me, when I do my assessment, I look at the person and I assess the body size. I look at all these different hairstyles that could possibly go. I look at the brand and the audience that they are, targeting.
That's huge. Mm-hmm.
That's major, because if you're targeting teenagers, you want to look a little different than if you're targeting somebody who's 50 years old. Okay. Or if you are a woman of a particular age, I don't want to dress you as if you're 25 and you're not. So I take all those things in consideration in coming up with this formula, if you will. And the thing is, once you come up with that, then I have to rely on the makeup artist. I have to rely on the hairstylist. And I have to rely on the fashion stylist.
Not exactly. I think rely is the wrong word.
Okay.
She's the creative director, so she tells them what she wants.
Well, you know what? I do kind of tell them
She tells them exactly what she wants.
But
we didn't rely on nobody. They did the work, technically, so she didn't put the color in. But trust and believe.
How about
she was right there, directing everything.
How about I rely on them to get it right?
That's fair.
That's probably what I was
trying
to say.
That's more in line with what really goes down.
But I will say this. I don't pick anybody that can't do the job right.
Yeah.
Because my expectations, again, are way up here. I will not give you a makeup artist that I have not used myself, seen their work. I have vetted them out. I have, because I have major, major connections in this particular industry. There is no way we're just going to use you as a sample. Okay. And, we're not doing that. So I have this vision. I have a concept, but I might rely on them to say, hey, I might do the eyes this way. And I will step in and say, no, we're going to do the eyes this way, because sometimes I'm the brand manager.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The team that I contract in, that I bring in to, create this look, I already have a vision, like Dr. Nadia said, but they don't know who your target audience is. I do. Okay. They don't know nothing about your brand. I do. They don't know the type of look that we're going for. I do. So it's my job to tell them, okay, we're not going to put green eyes on. And like this little thing my daughter puts in the inside right here, look like teardrops, but it's like yellow eyeshadow. I said, don't put that on my client. I know that's the trend, but that's not for us.
Mm-hmm.
So I get it, but we're not going into Vogue.
Right.
That'd be nice, but that's not the deal that we got. So I had to make sure that they're not too trendy. And it just depends. If I'm dealing with my young intern, Baby J. Baby J is a YouTube sensation. She is still in high school. She has like over 1 million followers. She's a whole different breed.
Mm-hmm.
She's a kid, She can wear all those wild things, but that's her audience. That's her demographic. That's who she caters to. So when it comes to knowing your personal style, Stella, the best thing to do is have that assessment.
Absolutely.
Is to have the assessment. And when I say assessment, I'm going to say, send me a picture. I need a picture from head to toe. Don't be wearing anything. I can't see what your body shape is, because everything is not for everybody. And, you know, hair. Look, this is the way I like to wear my hair, but I want something new. I want something different. I got to dig a little deep, because I have to know what's going on. Because if I don't know, I can't really serve you the best way. So, Stella, the assessment is probably the best answer to that, to be honest with you. And also keep in line with your target audience. You got to remember who they are. Because if they can't connect with you, then no dice. They then turn to one somewhere else. Okay, because if you are, you know, dealing with the youth and you look like a grandmama, that's not going to work. So we got to kind of tie it all together and make sure that we actually, you know, pull together our brand for our target audience as well. So I'm telling you, we had such a great time and the results were phenomenon. And, you know, I was thinking, Dr. Nadia, because since I done yours, I've gotten so many inbox messages. Mm-hmm. So many, oh my God, can you do me? Oh my God, you know, how do I increase my personal brand score? How do I do this and how do I do that? That I said, I hadn't really thought about, because I'm the people's champ. So I know what it is to be a new entrepreneur. Mm-hmm. I know what it is to be starting a business and I don't know how to get out there. Mm-hmm. So one of the things that I thought about, and I thought about this earlier today, because the one-on-one process makeover rather that we did with you kind of had the B-roll footage. We did the documentary. We did so much more because you were actually doing this launch. But I think about the people, the everyday entrepreneurs who are just starting, mm-hmm. Or those that want to start, they might not be able to have that $20,000 conversation and do what you did.
Right.
And because, I know I'm probably going to just, I can't help it. Because I've been there, done that. There was a time when I wish I had just a boost, like just somebody to just, can I get a portion of that?
Right, right.
Can I just get like one rib?
How much for one rib?
How much for one rib? Can I just get a portion of that just to get started?
Yeah.
Can I get a promo video and some landing page videos? Can y'all beat my face and fix my hair? So, and have some pictures. Can I just start with a basic package, mm-hmm. and then be taught, okay, now what do I do with these?
Mm-hmm. That's the big piece. It's, not, what it's do more I than do just it? Photos it's and videos. More than that. There's a lot that goes on behind the scenes.
What do I do with that? And I remember being that person.
Yeah.
I remember wanting to get this program. It was $25,000. I just wanted it because I saw somebody else doing it and it worked for them. But I didn't have $25,000. You know, did I think it was worth it? Yes, definitely was worth it. But I was just like, can I get like a little piece for maybe like $1,000? You know, because I wanted to get started. And I wanted to get started the right way with the right coaches, the right mentors, the right professionals, so that I don't have to keep going down the wrong road. I got with the right team that said, hey, go to the right, turn left. And if you go three blocks down, you're going to hit your target.
Yeah.
I don't want to figure it out. I don't want to, you know, figure out, well, how do I do this? How do I do that? Then how do I position these videos? Who going to show me that?
Right.
Because
right.
sometimes we'll shoot videos at home, which is nothing wrong with it. But now what?
Right.
Now what? And so one of the things I thought about was, I wonder if I could do something on a smaller scale for those that are just starting out?
That would be nice. But you know, before you get to that, because you may change your mind, how about we just show them some of the stuff?
Yeah. Good answer. So why don't we do this?
I'm on your laptop.
Huh.
So good. What we'll actually do is
look, I had it out too.
Ready?
We're going to show you guys the end result. I hate saying the end because
it's not over.
It's not over. Dead. She's not dead. It's not the end result to Dr. Nadia Brown, but I wanted to show you guys right after we did her personal brand makeover and did her recording for her lodge.
Yeah.
With Team PPI.
Yep.
And this is one of the videos that I directed and for the team. And right when we finished your whole, ta-da, look.
And I actually found a picture.
You found a picture
of me like a year, maybe about 6 months before. So I'll share that. So
we got a before and after.
We created our own before and after here. So give me a moment. And I'll share the screen.
Oh yeah, you got the camera.
So as you can see, this is Toby, my hubby. That was me at Womanpreneur 15. That was October 2015. So that was about maybe almost 4 to 5 months before we decided to.
You see, notice the dark hair.
Very dark.
You notice the dark hair, and that is down on. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just regular. It's not bad, because bad is bad. That's not bad. But it's just regular, and there's nothing wrong with that. But when you are just regular, you don't stand out.
Right.
And that's that was the missing piece, the missing mm-hmm. component. It was nothing wrong with her hair. There's nothing wrong with having dark hair. Everybody don't need color, by the way. Okay. But I had to figure out, what do I do with her hair? We're not cutting it. She has sister locks. It's not like you comb those out, you know, and start all over. I know some guys, they don't get it. You know,
right.
They don't get it. We won't mention any names. So, but I knew that. So what am I going to do? I could change the position of the hair and mm-hmm. do pin-ups, designs, curls. And I also could change the color, give it a whole nother look. But she still has her hair. She still has the sister locks. And you know, color grows out. It's not forever. And you just do it again, or you change the color, you whatever that is. But you always, you know, reinvent yourself. And so just notice the dark hair and the position. And we're going to show you what it looked like after the fact.
And here we are.
There are a lot of things that we think we should do when we start our business. Get our business card, figure out our logo, build our website, figure out our marketing plan, come up with social media. It's all so exciting. And yet, if you're not careful, it won't generate any revenue. I remember when I started my business, I spent a lot of time figuring out the name, spending time figuring out the logo, building the website, making updates, blogging. But I did spend enough time focusing on sales. Can we say I was a full-fledged member of Team No Sales? At one point, I remember sitting in my office working on some product line. I have no idea who I was planning to sell it to or even how I was going to do it. I just figured if I built a great product, they would come. They would just show up. The people would appear. But no one even knew who I was. I hadn't even worked on my marketing plan. And after going through this process of figuring out how to get out there, I realized that one of the bigger things that I was facing was fear. There was this fear of visibility, but more importantly, there was this fear of rejection. What happens when you put yourself out there? And now it's different when you work for a company, because you can blame a lot of stuff on them, but when it's your baby, your dream, your vision, there's a lot of risk there. What if people judge you? How would that feel? So I spent a lot of time in hiding. I did a lot of stuff. I had a great looking website. I had beautiful business cards. I attended networking meetings, but I avoided sales. I even started speaking. You know, you go out, you speak, you share information, you invite people to meet with you later, and you have these sales conversations. Do you know how many times I had sales conversations and even did sales presentations and yet didn't ask for the sale? Who does that? That's what fear will do. And at some point, you have to realize that fear is a liar. Fear will hold you back if you allow it. And so I spent the time to figure out how I can improve these skills. Because action eradicates fear. So you start taking the actions that you need to take so that the fear will go away. So a couple of the things that I took away from that entire experience was, one, just make the commitment. It all begins with a decision. When you make the decision to do something different, you then follow it up with action. I then had to find the resources that worked for me and a coach and mentor that fit me and my personality. And then I had to listen and be coachable and sometimes take some very, very difficult feedback. But one thing I can tell you, if you want to get away and no longer be part of Team No Sales, you have to be willing to not quit. It won't always be easy. It won't always be fun. But one thing I can guarantee you, it will definitely be worth it.
Ooh, woo! Did y'all see that? Mm-hmm. Can I get an amen in the chat box? Can I get an amen in the chat box? And the funny thing is, Joan said amen. The funny thing is, and thanks, Faye. Faye said that was an awesome makeover.
Thank you.
This is the thing, ladies. Y'all saw the before. Nothing wrong with the before. Nothing wrong. It was nothing wrong. She had on a blazer. She was with her man. There was nothing wrong. She's good, right? It's nothing wrong. But there probably was somebody else with their hair down long and dark with a blazer on. And there's nothing wrong with that either. How do we stand out? How do we get in front of the right people? How do people notice us? How do they know, oh, you see her over there? The pop of pink, like you said, in a sea of navy blue. Mm-hmm. How do you stand out? And when we did that, it's funny because, I mean, that was like a year ago, and I was watching it getting a little teary-eyed. I was getting a little teary-eyed because, you know, I work so, so hard to make sure that my clients show up great. Mm-hmm. And I push.
And push.
And I push. And people don't always like being pushed. But I thank God that you were able to say, all right, as strong as I am, I'm just going to release and let you do what you need to do. So giving me the permission to do what I wanted to do with you, the outcome was just, I guess because I haven't watched it in a while, and I was just like, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I know we both were like, ooh, that looked good.
Let's do it again.
It just looks good. And it looks good because you gave me full control. Mm-hmm. Because some people will say, well, no, I just want to do this part. I want to wear my old faithful wig that I always wear. And if I can't win that battle, then in my opinion, it's just okay. Mm-hmm. It's not at the top of their game because there's this component that, and it bothers me. But the client is the, you know, the one that makes the ultimate decision, the right. ultimate choice. Mm-hmm. So all I could do is give my suggestion, push until they start pushing back. Then you start saying, okay. But because sometimes I see something that they don't see.
Right. And I would just say, you know, like even with the launch, the piece that was really key was the videos, because that mm-hmm. was, so it wasn't just the makeover. It was that it was part of the process. And then a big portion of it, that was part of the pressure, because the big portion, like there were a lot of things that happened physically as far as the transformation, mm-hmm. but that was a very small part of the actual process, because a big part was getting me in front of the camera. And then, you know, doing all of the things that really made me uncomfortable. You think it's uncomfortable just sitting in a chair and not knowing what's going to happen to your hair. It's completely different, you know, now being on camera and going through that process. And so I think that, you know, that was one of the things that I could really appreciate, because sometimes people just see small pieces of it and you think, oh, Nadia just flew out and her and Larry just, you know, got the glam squad and they went shopping. She got some new clothes and some new hair.
We got some lipstick.
Right, you know, but there was a greater vision to that piece of it, and to do those videos, to do other things that we did with that overall makeover process was mm-hmm. huge. And, you know, and it was a big piece of the launch. And so as you're looking at your brand, you know, thinking about, like Lyric said, not just the wig, it's also, you know, how are you going to leverage that to move forward? Exactly. Not just the headshot, you know, there, those are elements of it, mm-hmm. but don't lose sight of the bigger picture.
Yeah, now what?
Right, now what? Okay, now you what? Have some cute headshots, and
now
you
what
know,
do you do with them?
How are you going to leverage that? And so, you know, how do you really show up mm-hmm. on video? Because one of my challenges with video really is, I focused for so many years to live audiences that it feels very awkward just talking into a camera. So how do you show up authentically when literally you're just talking to a camera? You don't have that audience feedback.
Right.
And to get that insight, and then of course have a strategy about how you're going to use that to leverage it to grow your business and expand your brand.
Yeah. And one of the things, guys, YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
We don't utilize it the way that we should, and getting it in front of our target audience, we got to use keywords. It's so much to it. I mean, like, we can go on for days on that. Has to be another webinar. How
yeah,
to use
I mean,
it.
You have an entire series.
Yeah,
like,
how to
how
use it.
Juice
because
you
I be
get.
Trying to give everything. I be trying to give y'all everything. But we do have 63 days here to become a powerfully profitable personal brand. And this is number one. And it's just so many pieces to it, guys. And I wanted Dr. Nadia to share with you her experience. You saw the before, nothing wrong with it, but you saw the after. And it was like, whoa, yeah, we notice her, you know? And you saw the videos that we did and the things of that nature. And I love producing pieces that have the wow factor.
Yeah, she's big into wow.
I'm very big into the wow factor. I'm very big into showing up, because everybody in your industry, they all look the same. You know how many transformational coaches there are? 1 million. You know how many speakers there are? 2 million. You know, it's a lot of people that do what we all do. Mm-hmm. It's not just we all, it's somebody every other time I turn around, somebody's an author. They probably didn't even write the book,
but they're an author.
Seriously, but they're an author. So we have so many people that do what we do, and sometimes we get a little discouraged because we're like, oh, everybody do that. I just pick something else. No, you just become great at what you do and stand out to where all they're going to think about is you. And at that point, everybody else that do what you do is irrelevant.
True.
It's irrelevant. McDonald's not the only one to sell burgers.
True.
What are they going to say? Well, you ain't going to sell no burgers because so-and-so's selling burgers. It just doesn't work like that, guys. Stand in your own power. You stay authentically you. You know why you do what you do. 9 times out of 10, you do what you do because you've been through it. And you want to help others come through it. Most of you all, especially the ones that I work with, I know that you are doing what you do and you want to help others because you had already been through it. Mm-hmm. This is your story. You can't change your story because somebody else got a story too. It doesn't work like that. This is the mama in me. It doesn't work like that. Because if you try to do something else that you ain't never been through or is not authentically you, it's not going to work. Okay? Stay in your zone and be great in it. Show up in it. Shine in it. Get your personal brand score up to the point where they have no other option but to say, damn, who is that? I want what she has. She looks like somebody I want to be connected to. What does she have to offer? They will start calling you. You over here looking for clients, get your personal brand up. They're going to be calling you. You know how many people come in my inbox once I made the decision to show up like a rock star? I've always been me, but they didn't know I existed. There were times I was confused, like, well, what should I do? Should I do this? Should I do that? I'm human just like you, but I made a decision to stand in my lane and do what I do best. But how do I outshine everybody else that do what I do? I had a hashtag, create my own hype. And sometimes you have to do that too. It is all about video. It's easier now to run a video than it ever has been and get in front of your potential audience for like $5 a day. Really? It's not that hard, guys. It's not that hard. It all depends on how bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? And this is for any industry. Let me get that part straight, because some people be like, well, maybe it's just for this or maybe it's just for that. No. You could be a realtor, you could be a coach. It doesn't make a difference. I have a client who does eyelashes and she teaches classes, always booked. Classes always full. And they're on a little mini tour, two young girls, young, like probably in their 20s young, like real young, but they are doing it. Mm-hmm. Their Instagram is on fire. But that's what it takes. But they have the pieces. Mm-hmm. You need the pieces to get started. Like I told you guys earlier, I know what it's like to want to get started, but I can't afford the big dogs, okay? The ones that I know have a track record of greatness. I get it. I understand it. I'm a single parent, been there, done that. And it's probably nothing you all can tell me, okay? I got the t-shirt too. But the thing is, I'm willing to make a sacrifice and come up with something that new entrepreneurs can afford and get their foundation pieces and get started.
Seriously?
That wasn't the game plan tonight, though. I'm just letting y'all know.
Really? That How can I be down? I may need to come back for a refresher.
That wasn't the game plan. I'm going to be honest with you guys. That wasn't the game plan. We got 9 weeks here. I didn't expect to say I would break down on week number one. I'm serious. Because I think if Dr. Nadia, I think if they could experience having a glam team.
Oh, it's phenomenal. I want to have a glam team every day.
Wake up in the morning, just fix my face.
And literally be like, I woke up like this.
I woke up like this, okay? And I'm breaking the internet. But I think everybody should experience the glam squad. So when you take your photos, they look right. Mm-hmm. When you do your videos, they look like your videos. Perfect. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because
how many videos we talking, Larry?
Well, you got to have a promo video. I can't send you out there without a promo video.
Okay, that's one.
You need a landing page video.
That's two.
You need one for your website, right? You need a thank you page video. If you're running a product, let's say you got an offer and or for the webinar.
Mm-hmm.
You could put a video on your thank you page too.
Yeah.
So where are we at? Three?
We're at three.
You need a commercial. How are you going to get them there?
Okay. That's four.
That's four.
So four videos and Glam Squad.
They need a logo reveal.
You going to create a logo too?
I'm so done.
But a video logo.
I'm done. I don't recall getting a video logo. I want to do over. Thank you very much.
And you had the big package too, right?
Oh. You see that?
That's
side eye.
That's five videos.
Glam Squad.
They gotta have some pictures.
And some pictures.
So a photo shoot.
Okay,
A mini one.
How many days?
Well, I gotta train them. Don't y'all wanna know what to do once you get the stuff? Seriously, all jokes aside, if you get five videos, a Glam Squad, and you cute, what you do next, right?
That's true. That's fair. Okay.
So that means...
So what you talking? 15,000?
That's less than 20.
It is less than 20. I'm just saying. How low can you go?
That's high.
You think so?
Let me say this. It's not high when it's one-on-one and you're getting the full package.
Oh, so this isn't going to be one-on-one? What were you thinking?
I'm thinking about having like a girl party. Like, a group of us come in.
Oh, that's high.
Because if we do it as a group, have lunch, tea, you know, girl chat.
Okay.
We could reduce the cost.
This is true.
Therefore, the savings I'll give to the ladies.
Okay. I like that.
What y'all think? Seriously, all jokes aside.
I'm looking at the chat box.
I know how
Bella
it is.
Bella said, come up with something, Leary. I need to get started. So you at least got one person that's down for the cause.
But I'm serious, though. I just know how it is. Been there, done that.
I have too.
I mean, I knew I had something inside of me that was so great, but I just didn't know how to get it out. And I'm a single parent, so I'm pinching all the pennies, you know. And I was a single parent going to Howard. I was really pinching the pennies, but I was great within. I just didn't know how to get it out. And all the big dogs that I wanted to coach me or, you know, show me things, it cost. I ain't got it. So can you just help me out a little bit? Give me a little something, something. So, yeah. So I'm willing to do that and give them something.
All right.
I like that.
Well, you got to tell the ladies what this something is. Don't keep us all in expense.
I can't believe that I did this.
I know, on week one.
On week one. Why show up? I'm going to tell you, we're going to do the doggone thing.
All right, dish it.
You're supposed to go through the 9 weeks and do it yourself. I'm going to tell you how to do it. Now I'm going to give it to you. I mean, wow.
Larry, Stella says, stop playing. My granddaughters say my moments of fashion desperation must come to an end.
All right, look, guys.
Joan said, go through 9 weeks.
We're going to go through 9 weeks because I've obligated myself to do Project 63. To do 63 days and then just do one ain't going to work. Because right. You still need the training. You still need the knowledge. You still need all of those good things. But you know what? I have a birthday in April. April 13th.
Hey.
Aries party.
Aries card.
I'm a 13th girl too, just different month.
So I think I should have like a birthday party / reshoot videos, girl chat.
Okay.
What y'all think about that?
I might fly out for that.
That'd give people time that aren't local to get here.
True.
Time for people that need a little, you know, managing of the funds.
True.
Been there, done that. People that, you know, want to get their brand assessment so they could be ready when they come in.
True.
You know, some ideas, because that's a process.
It sounds hot. Wait a minute. How many girls are we talking, though?
Not many.
Mm-mm. Oh.
Maybe 15. I thought about 10, but I think 15 would be the max. Because, and the reason why I say not that many is because I'm a hands-on person.
True.
Mm-hmm. So you guys know how I am when the camera's rolling. And I got to make sure that you show up great. So with you showing up great, I have to have my hands on. Mm-hmm. Now, the makeup artists, we got 3 or 4 of them doing your faces, glam squad, we got some behind the scene footage too.
Ooh, ooh, blooper reel.
Ooh, goodness, Jesus, give me strength. So, I have to give each lady my individual attention. I'm not going to send you in front of the camera alone with someone else. I have to have my hands in it. Okay. So I can't have my hands in 25, 50. So it has to be somewhere between 10 and 15.
Okay.
I think 15 max. Yeah.